Cereza spotted something that looked like fruit.
Looks good. Quick, let's go get it.
Cheshire enjoyed a snack as Cereza tried unsuccessfully to squeeze the pulp from her hair.
Do you have any idea how important hair is to a witch? Be careful!
No! All that fur on your head and a fat was of good it's done you. The demons you taught were surprisingly deft.
Quiet! I'm working on it. Just you wait. To go to places we couldn't before.
Thank you.
Cereza's heart leapt at the sudden voice.
Good question. Let's just say I'm the one you talk to when you want to know about the goings-on in this forest.
From the shadows.
Try asking me something if you don't believe me, and answer any question you have.
Okay, have you seen any black wolves around the forest lately?
Oh, but you're looking for a white wolf, aren't you?
How did you know?
You were a part of this forest now. That means your business has become my business. Trust in the path you take now. It's the right one. But you won't be able to find those elemental cores as easy as you think.
You know about the elemental cores too? Okay, tell me more.
Ahead, there's an old circus pit the fairies use to lure human children into the forest. The cranes ring my stand slaves for souls there to perform his shows until they die.
Until they die?
My apologies. Was that too scary? But you needn't worry. You and that demon of yours won't croak that easily. You've caused a big ruckus among those fairies since you entered this forest. That just proves they're scared of you. And that demon, of course. Well, I'm afraid I must go. I wish you both safe travels.
The voice faded away. And silence once again enveloped the forest.
And she's gone. Just who was that?
Cereza remembered something Morgana had told her long ago. Children who perish in Avalon become wisps, their souls cursed to wander the forest forever.
Hi there, little guy. Are you okay?
Who are you? Are you lost?
You can talk? I'm Cereza. What's your name? Troubled. Is something the matter?
My friends, the fairies took them away.
Colm's lower lip quivered as he spoke. He explained how the fairies would round up wisps and tease them for sport.
I want to go help them, but I don't stand a chance against those fairies.
Those mean old fairies to me.
What? The truth?
The wisp wasn't the only one surprised by Cereza's bold claim.
But we can't just abandon them.
Girl and demon squared off. Neither budged an inch. Cheshire made it clear he wanted no part in this daring rescue. But Cereza was determined.
Well, I'm going. Even if I have to fight those fairies myself. What is this place? Some kind of fairy playground?
Thank you.
here. I knew you'd come. You need my magic energy after all. Since you're here, how about lending me a paw?
Cereza was secretly happy to see Cheshire, but he was silently brooding.
Something happens to you, and it's my neck too.
The demon was just looking out for himself after all.
Well, with or without you, I'm still going to help those wisps. You just sit back and watch.
Oh, how's a weakling like you gonna save anyone?
The demon chuckled, his mouth twisted in a cruel grin. Pretending not to hear, Cereza pressed ahead.
Yeah.
Cereza teased the demon, who responded with a cold glare.
I strike any pest who come near. Unlike you, I have the strength to protect myself, chided the demon.